थैंक यू राहुल। नमस्कार, वेलकम टू ऑल। इट्स माय प्राउड प्रिविलेज टू वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू द गेस्ट गैदरिंग ऑफ ऑल एमिनेंट स्पीकर्स, पैशनेट एकेडमिक लीडर्स एंड डियर फैकल्टी मेंबर्स। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ AICTE, आई वंस अगेन वेलकम for the sensitization and counting the significance of AICTE awards before the all faculty members and institutions. AICTE has started awards and with your love and affections, we are successfully conducting from last few years. And to making the more participations from the institutions and creating the awareness among the all faculty members for the different awards which has been constituted for the different categories like best teacher awards, green clean campus awards, Leelati award for women empowerment, etc. So we have now today with August of gatherings and experts who will enlighten us about the significance of all awards. So I'd like to request Sri Giddhari ji, please take it forward and invite the experts for their brief. Thank you so much.
Thank you Dada ji. Sari dignitaries ko pranam, main pranam. Main sabse pehle Mittal sahab se anurodh karunga, Mittal sahab thoda Biswaswari best teacher award ke bare mein bataye.
धन्यवाद। विद इन 10 मिनट्स आई विल हाईलाइट टू यू रिगार्डिंग विश्वेश्वरी बेस्ट टीचर अवार्ड्स इंस्टीट्यूटेड बाय द ऑल इंडिया काउंसिल फॉर टेक्निकल एजुकेशन इन 2020। वी हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन अवार्ड्स टू टाइम्स, वंस इन 2020 एंड अनदर वाज इन 2021। नाउ द पर्पस ऑफ दीज अवार्ड्स इज to identify best teachers in the country, extraordinary teachers who have done some work, commendable work in five areas which we'll highlight to you shortly. The purpose is creating excellence in technical education. That's the purpose. Now, these awards are given on 5th September every year by our Honorable Minister of Education. The eligibility criteria for these awards is that only regular teachers who are regular in the AICTE approved institutions can only apply for this from engineering colleges and polytechnics. There is the age limit also for assistant professors and lecturers, whether he is in the engineering college or in the polytechnic. The age limit is 40 years on the date of application. For associate professors and head of department of polytechnics, the age limit is 50 years. And for professors or public principals of both institutions, the age limit is 60 years. So 40, 50, 60, beyond 60, the people cannot apply for this award. And only one award from one institution is accepted. You cannot, an institution cannot sponsor more than one person. Then most important aspect is that this award carries a medallion, a certification, and a cash prize of ₹25,000. The processes of these awards are that on the website of the AICT portal, complete information is given and a form is loaded. That form is to be filled by the candidates, got attested from the principal or the chief authority of the institution, and send it to the All India Council for Technical Education on the before the prescribed date, along with the details which are required to be filled by him or her. Now the criteria for this award is five types of things. One thing is the teacher has to find out, the teacher has to detail out teaching effectiveness. That what are the type of courses he has been teaching or in the total career before he applies. Duration taught, new courses developed, any innovations and development done by him or her, laboratory instructions, classroom performance, and everything regarding teaching effectiveness. There are the performer illustrate everything, and according to the performer, that applicant has to fill up that performer all the details. Second criteria is academic research. Academic research means here that how many number of persons he has guided for M.Tech on PhD, professorship of professional bodies, publications, citations, books written, and any editor of a journal, etc. So academic research primarily aims at what is the kind of research work the person at postgraduate and doctoral has performed. Third criteria is sponsored research. Means consultancy projects undertaken, faculty development programs, seminars, conferences, refresher courses organized or attended, research funding, how much money he has earned, patent developed, transfer of technology, product innovation, etc., etc. So basic purpose is to promote innovative capabilities into by the teachers in this award. The fourth one is academic public institution leadership public management. This means what are the positions the person has held: directors, principals, head of department, dean, warden, program coordinator, or any other thing like that. Co-curricular activities, sports, gyms, NCC, NSS, and contribution in NBA, NACA accreditation, community outreach, technical clubs, any other activities. In the academic leadership and management aspects, which are detailed out in the performer, has got to be filled in by the concerned teacher. Then the fifth point is outreach. In the outreach, what he has contributed outside the institution, like in charge of incubation center, industry institute, interaction cell, startups, contribution in rural development, extension services, village industry, recognition of awards and prizes, contribution to the government of India on various committees of the various other initiatives of the government of the or All India Council for Technical Education. So these are the five criteria: mean teaching effectiveness, academic research, sponsored research, academic leadership, and outreach. These five categories, performer is well designed, and the person is supposed to fill that performer according all the columns. And after that performer is filled, the for persons below professor's level have to get their performance certified by the head of the institution. and if principal is there, he has to certify that performer either by the director of technical education or if it is a private institution, by the chairman board of governors. So that performer, along with the a kind of a video clipping or a PPT, a video or PPT to show the exactly what the person has done, is also required to be sent. So once these awards are sent at the AICT quarter, they perform, they have constituted a body. And that body contains minimum of 3%. Now for 5%, 5-6% are there on the body, very senior professors. I am also one of the referee in that committee. Now there are three rounds. First, in the first round, we scrutinize large number of applications come up, more than 600, 700 applications, and we shortlist candidates. Around 125 people approximately we shortlist. In the second round, we shortlist, there are 20 awards, and we shortlist about 50 people for the purpose of these awards. Now the third is the personal interview, either through video or online. By now, we have been conducting on video only. So person has to justify for that award. The jury asks the questions, and there is a grading. I will just highlight within a minute or so because my time is passing now. And that jury, you know, recommends to, it is not necessary that we are going, the jury select all the 20 award winners. The best people are selected. Last year, we select, this year we selected only 17. Or previous to that year, we selected only 12. So it is not necessary that we are going to select all the 20. The best idea is that this is a national award which is given to the best teachers performed in the 5 years. So,
sir, mute ho gaye sir aap. Sir, aapki awaaz nahi aa rahi. Mittal sahab, aapki awaaz nahi aa rahi sir.
आ रही है आवाज?
अब आ रही है सर.
बाकी तो आपने मेरी आवाज आ रही थी ना?
हाँ बिल्कुल आ रही थी, एक 15-20 सेकंड के लिए.
आपको ये हाईलाइट कर दिया, ये सारी इंफॉर्मेशन आप वेबसाइट AICT की वेबसाइट से देख सकते हैं.
थैंक यू सर,
थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू वेरी मच, थैंक यू वेरी मच. आशा मैम, मैं थोड़ा सा परमिशन चाहूंगा, विनीशा मैम को कोई मीटिंग में जाना है तो मैं उनको पहले बुला लूं. Thank you,
Vinisha
ma'am. Now you can
tell
about
right.
Clean and Smart.
Am I audible now? Hello.
Yes, madam.
Okay, right. Thank you so much, and sorry that I have advanced my talk. But anyway, an active and environmentally conscious citizenry will create a sustainable world. So good morning to all the award aspirants from the education institutions and my comrades of AICT. So the onus of creating an environmentally conscious citizenry actually lies with all of you, that is from the institutions, and AICT is here to actually facilitate it. So our Clean and Smart Campus Award is primarily meant to create a sustainable world, which starts definitely from the campus. And now there are two words here, that is clean, which not only means cleanliness of the campus, that is waste management, and but it also implies clean air, clean water, clean soil, clean practices in terms of procurements, and also resource usage within the campus. And the second term is smart, and here it pertains to mainly capture of data of all the clean components within the campus. I'm sure Mr. Atharva will actually give you more inputs on what the smart campus in this in the true sense means. This award actually was constituted in the framework of AICT's Green Campus program, which is being implemented by International Institute of Waste Management. So if you look at the historical perspective of this award, that is since 2017, We have been encouraging campuses to implement the green concepts in a structured way and also to record them. Now, the response from the institutions were actually very overwhelming. In fact, the first time we had almost about 1,500 institutions, then it went up to 3,000, then again 5,000. So only last year, of course, because of COVID, we had a very low turnout. Then we were actually surprised to note that it's not just the participation, but most of the campuses already had eco-infrastructures in place. That's like the sewage treatment plants, composting facility, biogas, rooftop PV, water conservation, then equipments. So most of the colleges, only thing was that most of them outsourced these operations and maintenance to consultants, and they had no idea as to how it was functioning. But they all of them were spending a lot of money, so there was expenditure. But when we introduced the Green Campus program and also this award, what actually happened was that all these institutions actually, because we sought a lot of data, they started digging out the data, and that is when they realized that these infrastructure can be a revenue source. Even if they are not revenue source, at least a lot of money can be saved. So this was a good realization, and I'm sure that's the reason it was not just an award, but the benefits of this award was quite a lot. And when we got to know this, this was the feedback, that is when we introduced the smart component, which actually will capture this data, will help in trending and to make decisions in future. So for campuses, it was actually a lot of cost saving and benefits. And so in 2019, the smart component was added. Now, so I keep reiterating this, that this is not just an award. For every institution who actually participates in this competition, it is a great eye-opener. And they realize that the institution can, you know, save, to give you examples, 30% of energy bills just by simple practices. And those practices are also listed as questions in our questionnaire. Then for rainwater harvesting, wastewater recycling, they were almost able to cut down the bills of their water bills to almost zero. And this paper and e-waste management, they were able to also get some money. They were also able to create entrepreneurship within the colleges. So there were a lot of linkages with other schemes or programs of the government. So it's not just the Swachh Bharat scheme through which actually this program was introduced, but various other programs also got interlinked with this program, with this awards. So, and another major eye-opener for most of the institutions was that they almost 36 environmental regulation they have to comply with. And many of them did not know this. So all of us know ignorance of law is not an excuse. So when the before the Pollution Control Board officers come knocking to their door, they already are now prepared because of this award. And there are more than 100 questions in this. And these, once they answer it, they realize that they are streamlining the resources in their institution. And with that, many other things within the institution also gets kind of firmed up. So improvement measures, they are the most important than the award. If they're very good, they all of course get awards. And once they get awards, then there are benchmarks, because IWM has already established certain benchmarks, which are not only for India, but also looking at the world. So the sustainable development goals, how do we actually reach that? Because in India, we know that many of them, because of lack of data, we are actually saying that we have not done, like recycling. We claim that we have recycling ability of waste of only about 40%. But in reality, almost 80% is recycled, but we don't have data. So this kind of awards actually is going to help and it starts from the campus, as I mentioned earlier. And I hope that all of you, the institutions here, will participate, because participation here is most important in this program, so that you will reap the benefits. And of course, the country is going to benefit, because if you actually see 10,000 odd AICT institutions, if you participate in this program, that means almost a size of a state like Bihar is what is going to change, because that's the kind of area which is being covered by the institutions. So then some of the institutions are almost the size of a complete town. So if you do it, then it is the direct benefit is going to be for the country. And I hope that all of you would also participate in the Green Campus certification, because that is like a year-long program, and which will give you many other things, like how the students can participate, because even this program also encourages student participation, faculty engagement, and several other programs within the institution. So with this, I will hand it over to the AICT officials here, and thank hope you. All of you participate. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Pinita ma'am. Thank you. Apne sab bahut sare dignitaries hain. Rajan sir hain. He is a renowned person. Mitesh sir, pranam sir.
Ha, namaskar sir, namaskar. In fact, मैं दूसरे पहले मैं दूसरे लिंक पे जुड़ गया था.
अच्छा सर, प्रणाम सर. सर मैं थोड़ा परमिशन ले लूँ आपसे, मैडम आशा मैम को बुला लेते हैं.
हाँ हाँ सर,
आशा मैम.
नमस्कार सर. आलोक साहब नमस्कार.
हाँ नमस्कार सर, नमस्कार.
डॉक्टर मित्तल स्पीकिंग.
कैन आई स्टार्ट?
यस मैम, यस मैम.
थैंक यू. गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी, प्लेजर टू बी हियर. एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, I would like to applaud AICT for taking this wonderful step of honoring the memory of great role models for the education sector. Who doesn't know Vishweshwaraya ji? I think that's a great thing that they have done. And coming to know that these are new awards, it's even more creditable that the current chairman, vice chairman, and all have this vision to promote scholarship and leadership. So coming to the award that I'm going to speak about, and that is the Dr. Pritam Singh Award. I think we have just, AICT has just announced this year. And since it was the first time, there was lack of awareness, and we didn't get enough applications. But we would like to encourage everybody in the management space to apply. Just one minute I will take to talk about Dr. Pritam Singh. He has been the first Padma Shri in the field of management education, and he has been a great institution builder, having built IIM Lucknow, MDI, IMI, and made them world-class institutions. And so the reason why I'm talking about his qualities is that it has been an exemplary life, something where other management professionals should management scholars, teachers, professionals should emulate. And that is how these awards came into existence, to take a leaf out of his book, leaf out of the book of his life. So one is as an institution builder, and therefore I think there are two awards for institution building, leadership and institution building, and there are three awards for assistant professor, associate professor, and professor. And in all these, the focus is just as in the Vishweshwaraya Awards, focuses on excellence, focuses on innovation, focuses on application of knowledge, okay? And everywhere it is about being outstanding. And whatever it is that you're working on, please make it the best. Research, teaching, training, consulting, whatever it is that you're doing. I also want to say that this year, Pritam Singh Awards were announced along with the Vishweshwaraya Awards. And on the website, I think they were jointly presented or something. So on the portal, I'm talking about AICT portal. So the prominence did not come to the Pritam Singh Awards, which I'm sure the organizers from AICT will take care of this year. But I urge all of you to please disseminate information about this award. I think all of us, I mean, as management professors or engineering professors or anybody, we are... you know, there are not that many awards available, and we are not recognized to the extent that we should be recognized. And so from that point of view, I think when there are good awards, this should be disseminated and good people should be recognized. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Asha. Thank you very much. आपके जितने भी सजेशन से विल इनकॉर्पोरेट करेंगे मैं मित्तल साहब से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा. आलोक मित्तल साहब हमारे एक्स मेंबर सेक्रेटरी में भी एनएसआईटी में है, प्रोफेसर एंड डायरेक्टर. मित्तल साहब छात्र विश्वकर्मा अवार्ड है या जो भी आप बताना चाहें, आपका ही ये ब्रेन चाइल्ड है सारे.
हाँ, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी. मेनली मैं छात्र विश्वकर्मा अवार्ड के बारे में थोड़ा सा बस बताना चाहता हूँ. छात्र विश्वकर्मा अवार्ड बेसिकली स्किल डेवलपमेंट के ऊपर इसको प्रपोज किया गया है. इट इज प्रपोज अबाउट द ओवरऑल एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप डेवलपमेंट, स्किल डेवलपमेंट एंड इनोवेशन. सो दीज आर द मेन पैरामीटर्स इन छात्र विश्वकर्मा अवार्ड. सो फॉर लास्ट 4-5 ईयर्स वी हैव रिसीव्ड वेरी गुड response about this, and every year we get very good innovative teams for this award. So this, the basic aim is the skill development, skilled about the technical education, is how the skill have to be developed amongst the students, and the innovative practices, more innovative practices should be motivated among the students. So these are the main parameters about Chhatra Vishwakarma Award. Of course, there are other awards which are already been told. Professor Alan Mittal have told it very well, the Teachers Award, and we काफी अच्छा इस बाकी awards के बारे में बताया. So I don't take much of the time. I think other panelists will give their views about our other awards.
Thank you, sir. आप आए सर, बहुत बहुत हम कृतज्ञ हैं आपके. मैं डॉक्टर आर्यकर साहब, थोड़ा हिना मैम को ले लूं, आप कहें तो. नहीं,
श्योर सर, एज यू विश.
सर, हिना मैम ने लीलावती अवार्ड के हमारे फाउंडर हैं. वो बहुत सारे हमारे जितना भी डॉक्यूमेंट है, स्कीम डॉक्यूमेंट है, उसमें बहुत ज्यादा पार्टिसिपेशन रहा. तो हिना मैम.
Thank you. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you to AICT and all the esteemed members present here who are connected in this common digital platform, and those who are listening to us through the other platforms. Basically, Leelavati ka jo genesis hai, it's very special to all of us because the award was premised on the National Policy for Women 2016 lines by touching upon various issues like health, education, economy, environment, sanitation, decision making, violence against women, skill development, how to promote an enabling environment, climate change, and of course environment. And much more beyond what you can see or think. So the Leelavati Award, of course, is a prestigious take for AICTE because it aims to recognize the efforts made by the AICTE institutions and individuals towards their contribution in the area of women's empowerment. So, in accordance with the role which has been highlighted in the National Policy for Women, and in order to enable women to attain their full potential, we came up with in all spheres of life, and to make women as powerful agents of social change, the Leelavati Award was designed. And it has been so carefully designed, and the parameters have been crafted very carefully in accordance with what our country is looking out for, because we see that women are major contributors to the GDP. They are engaged largely in unorganized sectors. They are invisible in the economy, but they are visible contributors in national development. So I'd rather like to put it this way, that through this award, all the students of AICT regulated institutions, individuals and teachers, they can volunteer and can facilitate opportunities for marginalized women in the areas of skill development, technology usage, education, employment, digital literacy, you name it, health and nutrition, and much more. There are five themes that have been covered in the Leelavati Award. Women and adolescent health. We have stressed a lot on adolescent health, because initially when the award was instituted last year, we just called it women's health, because India has the largest population of adolescents in the world. And the Human Development Index shows a lot of disparities in terms of health, nutrition, maternal mortality. And in every sphere, you see that there is a lag. So we decided to keep it as, call it as women and adolescent health. Then we also have self-defense, environmental sanitation and hygiene, literacy and life skills. Life skills got attached to literacy because we know that it's not just literacy in today's day and age, but a lot more beyond literacy, which you know, tends to contribute to women's personality development and empowerment. Then women's entrepreneurship, of course. Legal awareness is another theme. Technology for women got added this time because women are seen to be the driving forces you know, for the adoption of any kind of technology. So their technology is contextualized in terms of gender. Technology is socially contextualized. So how the benefits of technology can be accrued for women. So that aspect, then of course, women innovators in rural and urban areas, how their credit needs can be met, how they can be linked to micro finance, banking, and so on. And all of you must be familiar about all the things that work at the ground level, like self-help groups, formation of collectives, and all. So it all runs through the entire context of women's empowerment and development. And of course, fulfillment of gender needs, their credit needs, their technology needs when it comes to entrepreneurship. And of course, a lot of creativity has got added into what we designed initially and now, because we see that women are also creative here. So students need to themselves come up with creative ideas so that women who, you know, in terms of technology diffusion, not just innovation, women are most adaptable. So for instance, you can, students can create digital platforms to enable women in forming networks of business groups, or even for the mutual benefit of women in terms of social and economic gains, you know, thus they can build their confidence. So a lot of parameters we came up with while designing this award, but the slip that happened last time by the individuals and institutions was that many of them could not generate data in terms of us as evaluators to you know, see how much they have contributed across the span of women's empowerment. So the measurable gains were missing. For that, we have added more marks. The proportion of women who benefited also, for that we added more marks. We've removed location, you know, location as a parameter got removed, because any activity, whether you do it closer to the engineering institution or further away, it is need specific, need based. It could be location specific. So irrespective of location, aapne kitna dur rakhe koi activity ki hai, we removed that criteria, because any kind of issue or problem constraint that is prevalent in a community, for instance, anemia, that can be location specific only, whether it is close to the institution or further away. So these are certain small changes which we introduced in the parameters. their marks would be given. So like what Dr. Asha highlighted and Dr. Mittal and Benisha also said, you know, we need to actually showcase these awards in a big way, get onto social media. AICT needs to really push these the promotion of these awards so that we get more applicants, because I'm sure a lot of institutes, and of course in the area of STEM also, there has to be a larger presence of women, their role in engineering colleges, science institutions. That also will get covered in the Leelavati. So I think I've been able to cover all of it. Regarding how candidates, the institutions will get shortlisted, that the experts who spoke before me have already spoken in detail. So I'd not dwell on that more. And with this, I'd like to close my bit. And thank you for giving me a chance. Thank you.
Thank you, Hema. Thank you. मैं डॉक्टर रमेश कुमार जी गर्ग साहब को आमंत्रित करूंगा कि वो उत्कर्ष संस्थान विश्वकर्मा अवार्ड के बारे में बताएं सर.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू वेरी मच. दिस उत्कृष्ट संस्थान विश्वकर्मा अवार्ड, फर्स्ट आई विल गो थ्रू द मैंडेट ऑफ एआईसीटी वेयर इट इज क्लियरली मेंशन दैट दिस USVA, Utkrish Sansthan Vishwakarma Award, that is aimed to motivate and recognize and honor the AICT approved institutions to raise their performance in the specific domain of leading to significant contribution for the growth and development of the society. Here, this word, that is society, it is very important word. Now, in engineering institutions or technical institutions, what we people speak, we always talk about industry institute interaction, that is III. Industry as well as institute, these are the two stakeholders in terms of technical education. But in case of this award, when we speak about the society, this society is the third stakeholder, and these three stakeholders, that institute, industry and society, they form a triangle. When they are forming a triangle, means they are dependent on each other. For example, when we talk about industry institute interaction, it means we have to work, we have to provide the manpower compatible with our industrial needs. But to whom the industry serves? The industries, they serve to the society. Then this relationship between the institute, industry and society, that is based on technology. Technology is one thing which keeps them close to each other, all the three stakeholders of this technical education. Of course, when we go for the institution, another stakeholders or institute that covers faculty, students and the regulators. Regulators means maybe the management of the institute or maybe the AICT. Statutory bodies, if I speak. Now, if I consider the role of the statutory bodies, they went for this kind of start of. This type of awards. And why this interaction and this type of award is important is, for example, when a student, he starts going to schools, maybe in the 6th, 7th or 8th standards, then he is informed about, you can say, through the way of history, maybe like ages of civilization, where we talk about Stone Age, Bronze Age, Iron Age, industrial revolutions, or maybe information age. Then what is the purpose is, if you talk about the society and technology, they are reciprocal to each other. Means the society that drives the technological change, and this changing technology that shapes the society. That's why this is the importance of technology, and this technology is binding all the three stakeholders of the society. Now, the another question is why this award is important, or how it can help the institutions for the betterment of the institute, or to get recognition for any institute. Yes, this is an you can say maybe you can say hidden, but of course nowadays we people we try to get a different kind of accreditations. If I talk of all institutions, they tried for accreditation from NEC, maybe different grades, 7 grades, they are awarded by the NEC. We go for by NIRF rankings. We go for accreditation through National Board of Accreditation for engineering courses. This award is quite helpful, and it serves, you can say, to secure marks under different kinds of acts. Some of them I may name. If we talk about the curriculum as per NEC, then we talk about the values. We talk about the environment and sustainability. This environment and sustainability, they are directly related to the society. And because this Vishwakarma Award, that is for the Sansthan to work for the development of the society, that's why it is a part of curriculum in that way, where it will help you. Teaching learning methodologies. When we talk about participative learning, we talk about problem solving. By means of this kind of award, we have to work for the society. And when we are working for the society, we need a, you can say, combined effort, a team effort of students, faculty, management, and the society. That is nearhood, neighborhood. That's why it is one kind of participative learning or problem solving. Another is, if I talk about research innovation, then this is, you can say, one kind of ecosystem for innovation. Where we can talk about the creation and knowledge transfer. We are creative knowledge. When we are doing some work for the benefit of the society, it means we need to be creative, or we are technology, we are transferring the technology. If I talk about inclusivity, this is another parameter. We need inclusivity. Research is enhanced by means of that may come in terms of patents. By all this, we can say that this is not only, you can say, simple award, but this kind of award, it is very helpful for the overall growth and development of the institution. Just to secure recognition at different platform, at international as well as national level. Of course, along with others, in this award is based on a particular theme that is announced by the AICT. For the years, maybe now AICT is going to announce for the year 2021 based on certain topic. In last 2 years, AICT has taken up due to this pandemic, India fights corona. And one topic was how to enhance the income of the villages. As far as evaluation is concerned, eligibility and evaluation is concerned, all technical institutions of the Republic of India, they're eligible to apply for this type of award. And as far as evaluation is concerned, there is a three-tier evaluation in this case. First, the applications are shortlisted by a group of experts, by a team of experts. In the second case, they go for presentation by the shortlisted institutions. And in the third stage, there are certain visits just to recognize the, you can say, what the institute has done really in the villages or for the society. This is three-tier system of evaluation. I think that's all about this type of award. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vivek sir. Thank you very much, sir. आपको सुनना हमेशा अच्छा लगता है. मैं अथर्व और सिंधे सर, अभी सिंधे सर अपने पास हैं. राजेंद्र कुशिंदे जी, चेयरमैन टेरी पॉलिसी सेंटर्स के हैं. क्लीन एंड स्मार्ट कैंपस के बारे में और थोड़ा सा बताएंगे तो अच्छा रहेगा, क्योंकि ये एक मेजर अवार्ड है और बहुत सारे कॉलेज पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे हैं इसमें. और जैसे बताया कि एक्रेडिशन वगैरह में बहुत ज्यादा हेल्प करता है, बहुत जगह चीजें हेल्प करता है. तो अथर और सिंधे सर दोनों इस पर बताओ.
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग.
हाँ सिंधे सर,
गुड सर. यस, आई वाज नॉट सपोज्ड टू पार्टिसिपेट. आई एम इन AICTE. आई हैव बीन रिक्वेस्टेड टू take the seat of Dr. Datta, who has been urgently called by the chairman. So we have decided that Atharva, who has taken a great lead in participating in a Clean and Smart Award, and I totally agree with Vinisha that it is no longer an award, it is a movement. It's a huge movement of students and the faculty who are working in making their campus clean and smart. And Atharva is the right person to say what exactly you mean by smart, because everybody knows clean. And we don't know what is a, whether it is a street smart or real smart or just a show of smart. And I think he will explain exactly what it is. Exactly what it is. Suffice it to say, that I think there is a new emphasis on carbon neutrality. And I think in the future award, because our Prime Minister made an announcement that by 2070, India will be carbon neutral. And if India has to be carbon neutral, I think the best place to start for making it carbon neutral is the university campus. And we will be making certain changes into it. Plus, I know that there is a tremendous commitment from AICTE to make sure that the whole thing becomes sort of a lifestyle management issue and making every student what is called as a SDG ready for sustainable development goals. And our Prime Minister keeps on saying that the whole issue is about a lifestyle. There's no other issue. If we change our lifestyle, I think all things will be in a balance, which we have disturbed that balance at present. After Atharva speaks, I will give some suggestions from my side, because I was involved in this designing the whole climate, this clean and smart award, and how it is going now, I will speak about it. But I was very pleased to see number of other awards which are coming up. And we heard about Chhatra Samstha, Utkarsha Samstha Award, we heard about Chhatra Mitra Award, Pritam Singh Award, number of other things are coming up. And I think that itself shows that Clean and Smart Award movement is gathering a momentum. So I would like to request Atharva to give his views. Atharva?
Yes, sir. Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay, thank you so much. So as you all are aware, this award is constituted by AICT with Tere Policy Center and IIWM, of which Binisha Madam is the founder director there. So as we all are aware, Swachh Bharat mission is to make cleanliness in all walks of life with motto of Swachh Bharat and Swasth Bharat. But it is also evident that any long-term solution to complex problems related to environment sustainability comes with a lot of research. And fortunately, many of the digital technologies are well poised to offer the solution. The rising use of technologies, especially the IoT, which is Internet of Things, robotics, cloud networking, have an immense potential to remodel a campus into smart campus. And that is the reason this award was constituted and an aspect of smartness was added into it in 2019. So till now we have had two awards under the 2 years of Clean and Smart Campus Award. So the smart campuses would construct the smart citizens, those who are future ready as well as SDG ready, as Dr. Shinde mentioned. The efforts of students, faculties and administrations of an institute may turn out to be game changer for institutions through the networking model envisions, which is Smart Campus Cloud Network, which is a network of universities where you can share your experience in making your campuses smart. So Clean and Smart Campus Award is a unique initiative by AICT in the country to coalesce the efforts of stakeholders and incentivize the youth working towards it. So for that, there are three major, looking at the scope of the award, there are three major categories for this award. One is the standalone institutions, one is the degree colleges, and third is the universities or deemed to be universities. So these are the three categories in which educational institutes are awarded for majorly three aspects. One is clean aspect, like the clean initiatives that have been initiated into the campuses related to the green cover, waste management, as well as other parts which are connected to the cleanliness. Second aspect is the smart campus aspect, in which how the
सर कह रहे हैं कि कुछ तो करा दे, कुछ नहीं तो मैंने तो मना किया, हमने कहा क्या करा दे।
प्लीज बीआईटी ट्रिपल ई म्यूट करें हमने आपको, म्यूट करें हमने आपको।
So the second aspect is the smart campus, in which how the digital technologies, information of things, cloud networking is used by the campuses to attain sustainability as well as to monitor their sustainable activities that are going on in their campuses. So this are the two aspects, and third aspect or the category, third aspect for each category is the AICT's new environment policy.
मुझे तो कुछ भी नहीं पता, मैं तो कल अभी नहीं हूँ, मैं तो कल अभी नहीं हूँ।
So the initiatives taken up by the campuses under the environment policy of AICT are also considered while giving this award to the campuses. With that, from the past year, we have started a fourth category award, which is a very special and unique award, which is the Indian Knowledge System Award. And this award is specially for those campuses who are making interventions in their regular academics related to Indian knowledge system. So we all are aware that Ministry of Education has introduced this Indian knowledge system, and AICT is a major force behind implementing the Indian knowledge system part. So this is the fourth award, fourth category award that has been conferred to the campuses. So as like Ms. Benisha said, like we are getting multiple entries for this award. So it is basically an online structure where you have a like vast questionnaire with n number of activities which you do in your campus, and you need to fill in the data which is required. And with that, you have to provide evidences. What are the exact evidences with photographs or videos which of the activities which you are doing? And for the smart aspects, like for metering, if there is a smart metering, you can provide the data which is related to, for example, energy consumption or water consumption through it. With that, after shortlisting the whole list of campuses, there is expert visit. But last year, due to COVID, it couldn't be happened. So it was a virtual examination of the campuses, and a panel of expert committee examined each category accordingly, and then the award was conferred. With that, the IKS cell in AICT worked for giving out the award for the Indian knowledge system. So this is what we can say, the overall gist of the AICT's Clean and Smart Campus Award and its constitution to making tangible contributions to the sustainable development goals, as well as making the campuses a pilot for sustainability. This year also there is another one thing I would surely like to mention, that the award certificate which was conferred this time had a QR code like embedded on it. So this QR code is very special because AICT has planted a tree in the name of that institution, and using that QR code, when you scan that QR code, you can know the exact current situation of that tree, its current dimension and all the things. So I think it is a great step which AICT is taking towards conservation of environment, and that shows AICT's commitment toward environment conservation through this Clean and Smart Campus Award, as well as the tree plantation on behalf of the campus with the conservation of that tree. So this was the idea of Clean and Smart Campus Award. So now I would like again request Dr. Rajendra Shinde to please speak on it.
Okay, Gautam, I will take only a few minutes. And probably wrap up our TARE Policy Center's intervention here. I think Atharva very well explained how the things are and how it is improving the whole awards and all that. As I said, it's not just an award, it is a movement. And what is important is the participation of students more and more. So in future, our questionnaire or our queries that we will ask the campus is to see how much of it is done by really the students, and how much is done by the faculty, and how much is by utility managers and administration part of it. Because we are not trying to develop the capacity of administration people, but of students and the faculty. So that is one aspect I would like to say. And the second thing is, there are a number of institutes probably remaining out of this because of this UGC and AICT domains. And probably try to see how these two entities can come together to make sure that it becomes a national, nationwide movement and doesn't restrict it to AICT related institutes and UGC related universities. So that is the one suggestion that I would like to make. The other one is saying that there is a tremendous urgency in terms of taking action on sustainable development goals and particularly climate action. So that kind of urgency should be shown by way of telling that, look, it's not just an annual award, but we also want to track your performance. That, let's say today, Institute A wins the award, and then they rest on their laurels, and that there is a complacency. We also want to see that Institute A has further improved the next year. And that tracking system, that we need to develop it. And this is what I was discussing with Dr. Jere, how we can develop that kind of a tracking system, taking the output from the clean and smart award. The other thing is I mentioned about carbon neutrality, which is becoming a central issue, because all other issues are probably have their existential threat if the climate neutrality is not taken care of. And I think that also needs to be tracked very well. The other thing is giving up fellowships, apart from these awards, giving the fellowships to carry out certain research which they have started in the campus is another thing that we can take up. And this fellowship should come from AICTE, and it should be innovative. I know there are already fellowships being done, and the experts talked about it. But this fellowship could be related to the Indian innovation. We're not talking about a waste. See, India has its own style of working, which our Prime Minister keeps on talking about. We have our own tradition, working with the nature, finding the nature solution rather than getting a synthetic solution. And if any institute would like to take up, or any student would like to take up such kind of things, we should have such fellowships awarded based on our research on clean and smart award applications. And lastly, see, we as a jury, and we have seen that there are some sparks in application. They have done something more than what we expect them to do. And such case studies should be documented, and probably in a form of a soft book or the e-book, and should be disseminated well. If any particular institute or the college or university has crossed their borders and gone beyond what is expected in the Clean and Smart Award, that should be definitely documented and should be reached out, not only to our university, but the our university network abroad. And with that, I stop there, Dr. Garg. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Thank you, Sindhu sir. Thank you very much, sir. नाउ मैं अब बुलाना चाहूंगा जो हमारे अवार्डीज है उनका एक्सपीरियंस शेयर के लिए बुलाना चाहूंगा. तो सबसे पहले जेनेट मैम जो कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा कॉलेज से है वो हर बार कुछ ना कुछ अवार्ड लेके जाते हैं. तो प्लीज शेयर योर व्यू रिगार्डिंग अवार्ड्स, हाउ यू फील, हाउ यू कंट्रीब्यूट एंड हाउ यू गेट द अवार्ड.
थैंक यू फॉर द अपॉर्चुनिटी सर. And we are very pleased to share our experiences and what went inside, or the working that went inside in getting the awards. I would like to say on this platform that whatever award ACT constitutes, we make sure that we are part of it. So we walk the extra mile to get the award, and we feel very happy to work as a family to get the award, sir. Now, with respect to the Clean and Smart Campus Awards, the Clean and Smart Campus has, as already sir pointed out, there are two components to it, clean component and smart components. And it is like changing or improving the complete ecosystem in which we do things. As regards the clean component, we have a very lush green area and we maintain it. This is a dedicated set of staff for both solid waste segregation at the source. Composting pits are there, liquid waste segregation. We have STP plants, and the water which is getting recycled, we're going for 100% recycling of the water, and that is used for gardening purposes. So that makes our campus clean and green, I would say. And not only that, along with the students, faculty, and their families together, we have planted around 10,000 species of trees in our campus. It was a joint initiative by the whole Krishna family. And we have more than 50 species of plants and trees, which is planted in our campus, like plants with this part of the region, like, for example, Ashoka, Magiram, Kumuli, so on and so forth. So it's 50 variety, more than 50 species of plants we have planted in the campus. And with that, we got that One Student, One Tree Initiative Award. We got the award in that initiative also. And with respect to the waste management, I have already said that it's 100% recycled water is used for gardening. So waste cycling is happening there. And campus energy management, all the forms of energy we have adopted. And then we have got this high volume, low speed fans, which is installed in all our reading rooms, in our library, etc., which consume very less energy. Therefore, 96.33% of energy efficient appliances are operating in the campus. And we have gone to solar energy capacity, which is installed, and that is giving the energy for all our hostel blocks and all our the lamps on the road, and also for the classroom blocks, and so on and so forth. And with respect to smart campus management, our institution, we have all classes. I should say that 115 classrooms have got smart classrooms. They got smart boards. So that has helped us in blended learning and flipped learning. And our honorable ACT chairman also, once when he visited, he appreciated our institution for the blended and the flipped learning. And we have got 24/7 Google classrooms, in which all the assignments and all the materials are they're posted on the Google classroom, and a very close WhatsApp groups. So that has helped us in the new norm also, that adapting to the new norm. So adapting to the new norm during pandemic has come, but we practiced it for the past 5 years or more. So we have a blended and flipped classroom learning model. And our USP, I should say, that we have a e-newsletter, sir. Every day we release a e-newsletter to our WhatsApp groups, to our all our stakeholders, to our students, to our alumni, their parents, and the corporates, etc., all stakeholders, so that whatever is happening in the campus, any events happening in the campus throughout the day, by the end of the day, the stakeholders can view that. So we have an e-newsletter there. So that has made our campus smart, I should say. And whatever projects that we do, this automated irrigation project, automated sensor devices which we have installed, automated biogas safety, all those are automated, and it's a joint exercise projects by our faculty team and also with the student team. That has resulted in a smart and clean and green campus, I would say. And that has resulted in the awards in the consecutive years, like 2019 and 20, we got second rank, third rank, respectively. And Swashta also, we got second rank in 2019, sir. And with respect to USWA, Utkrish Sansan Vishwakarma Award, we have adopted the nearby villages, like three villages we have adopted. And we have trained the women folk who are actually, they are not the breadwinners. They are just the homemakers in the villages. We have called them, we have empowered them by teaching them how to do millet production. We have a unit in our institution which operates under DST seed funding. So we give them training for millet food production, like ragi and other food products. And we have also empowered them by giving them some funding to establish a shop there in the village. Now all of them have turned entrepreneurs. So we are very happy in that, and that again resulted in the Utkrish Sansan Vishwakarma Award, I should say. And and for the research and the research citations and the outcomes, I also received a Vishweshwara Award as well. So in essence, as all the dignitaries were speaking, it's not like just participating and getting the award. It's like, how do we improve the ecosystem of the institution? And it should be a joint exercise by both the faculty, the students, stakeholders, and the outside world, the neighboring world in which we are connected. During the pandemic time, we also developed an indigenous sanitizer. We called it as Pura. And we distributed it free of cost to the neighboring villages which we have adopted in and around our region. We are appreciated by the government also. And I would say that participation is the key. We start something and we slowly, and then we progress towards it. But the ultimate goal is to be economical and also sustainability, improving a holistic ecosystem of the world at large. So I'm very happy that our institution has made a small contribution in this regard. Thank you, sir, for the opportunity.
Thank you very much. Everyone is feeling excited. Now I'm inviting Vikas Bale sir. Last year best teacher award mila. So Vikas Bale sir, please share you can share your experience.
Sir. Yeah, thank you, girl sir. First of all, I am extremely gratified for this award, and I want to appreciate the jury members for their hard work and tireless effort for choosing me as a best Vishveshwara best teacher awardee. So thank you each and everyone. If you see that this process, that this entire process of the application is very simple and very easy for each and every professor who can apply this, who is interested to apply for this award. All criteria which are mentioned and said by Mittal Saab, it's very in detail and well defined. So if you see that, the good thing in this process is that this whatever we are saying or presenting from our side, that we need to support with the documents, and this uploading of the documentation on the portal is very simple and very easy manner. So these all documents, whatever we are just claiming that we need to put it on the portal. Parameters considered which are required for the best teaching learning processes which enhance the quality of the outcome based education. Next one is that in the if you see that there are the great outstanding jury members are there, and the contribution of these personalities was really commendable in the entire process. Then if you see this, the entire the function which is held at this AICT on the 5th of September 2021, it was amazing and well organized, well disciplined. And I think that the contributions given by this Mamta Agarwal, I should not forget her, and the Amit Datta ji and his entire team, it was a really great. And the entire function which is held at the AICT auditorium, it was very smooth and very friendly. We start our journey from our resident to the reach to this auditorium and returning back. Entire care has been taken by the AICT. It's really great. I think that this is the amazing to each and everyone. So I think that this is my experience, and this all credit goes to entire AICT chairman and entire his team. So thank you from my side.
Thank you, Vale sir. Thank you very much.
सर यू आर म्यूट गर्ग साहब आप म्यूट पे हैं
डॉक्टर अशोक पिसे सर हाँ सर प्लीज शेयर योर एक्सपीरियंस अबाउट अवार्ड आवाज नहीं आ रहा सर अभी आपका अशोक सर आपका आवाज नहीं आ रहा सर
गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू I thank to the AICT first. They have chosen our college as a Vishwakarma Award for this. We have developed in the air conditioner PP kit, and this faculty along with the students has developed this kit. So he will explain, Dr. Suhas Deshmukh. He will explain the how he has developed this kit.
Okay, thank you, sir.
In short, you have to do.
Okay, I will give you the our experiences, how we have progressed this PP kit and how we have developed it. Actually, it was started in when pandemic was in critical situation, when no one is going out of the house and everyone is locked in the house. So that time our hostel was initiated as in a quarantine center. We are heading for it and we are controlling that all pandemic situation. Then I had a discussion with some of the doctor with a hospital like Krishna Hospital nearby, Krishna Hospital. Then we had plenty of the discussion, and then we came to know that the doctors are facing big difficulty when they are going into the hospital and treating the student, treating the patients. During this, they are facing big difficulty that the entire PPE kit, they get sweated, then they have some health issues like skin diseases or something. Then we decided to have a certain solution for this. Why cannot we provide an air-cooled kind of a PPE kit, which will create a more comfort, and then health worker can also work in more comfortable manner, and they can do a better treatment to the faculty, for the patients. And that's what we have decided. We have created in a group of the students, four students group, and then we decided to deploy and work. But these students were staying in their home. Then we had plenty of the online meetings. Then we designed an entire kit, which basically used a Peltier effect as a cooling effect for cooling the entire kit in from inside. And then we provided whatever the material required for development of this. And then at least 3 to 4 iterations, we came up with a solution that why cannot we have a battery operated in a PPE kit. And then we developed it. Then we have given at least more than 10 PPE kit to the Krishna Hospital. They use that PPE kit, and that PPE kit, we have done some pilot study, and it is observed during this pilot study that whatever the doctors or health workers are more comfortable using this PPE kit. And that is the basically aim, because pandemic has given us an opportunity to have such innovative solutions for this pandemic situation. And that is the basically good thing it was happened from our students group and our faculty group. And we are very much thankful that this entire innovation was recognized by AICT and entire AICT team. We visited to AICT campus during this award, and we had a very nice experience that all the faculties or all the dignitaries from AICT coming to our stall, and they're visiting, asking this, how they have developed and everything. But it is really appreciated by all the people, and we are very much thankful for such type of an activity initiated by AICT. And as well as I would like to have one more comment onto this. Why cannot we have such situation-based innovation kind of an award? Situation comes, and then students are more innovative. If we put up some problem in front of them, they can do a very nice innovative solutions for situation. So why cannot we have such kind of an award in future, so that student will get more encouragement? And obviously this encouragement leads to a better technology in our country, and that to be in-house development is most important. That is what we would like to do.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. And thank you for giving us an opportunity.
It's our pleasure, sir. We are very grateful to all awardees and all jury members and all our respected speakers. सबसे पहले मैं थैंक यू एक संस्कृत का श्लोक है बहुत फेमस श्लोक है संगे छद्म लेट्स मूव टुगेदर इट्स ऋग्वेद का लास्ट श्लोक संगे छद्म लेट्स मूव टुगेदर व्हेन वी आर मूविंग टुगेदर वी कैन चेंज एनीथिंग आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू ऑल कर्मयोगी स्पीकर्स आई एम टेलिंग इट सबसे पहले मित्तल साहब आलोक मित्तल साहब एल एन मित्तल सर आशा मैम एंड हिना मैम आर के गर्ग साहब राजन शिंदे सर विनीशा मैम एंड अथर आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू ऑल द स्पीकर्स बहुत शॉर्ट नोटिस पे आप लोगों ने हमें समय दिया एंड यू शेयर एवरीथिंग एंड एक और कहावत चरितार्थ करती है कि ऋषि नाम यत्न अर्थानु धावते यदि कोई एक्सपीरियंस आदमी किसी चीज को बोलता है तो उसका अर्थ अपने आप चला जाता है So you are overall experienced person and you are telling something, it's go deeply. बहुत ज़्यादा between the lines में बोलने युद्ध नहीं सिंधे सर और इतने experienced लोग बोल रहे थे तो वो चीज़ अपने आप जा रही थी अंदर से and very grateful to our chairman, vice chairman, member secretary and advisor ma'am Mamata Rani ma'am and Datta sir and all awardees. In future, you are the आइकॉन फॉर अस, यू विल प्रमोट अवर एक्टिविटीज. तो मैं तो आपसे यही अनुरोध करूंगा कि आप जितने ज्यादा हमारे बारे में बोलें कि क्या क्या अवार्ड मिले, आपको कैसे मिला, उतना ही ज्यादा अच्छा है. जितना ज्यादा लोग पार्टिसिपेट करेंगे उतना हमें अच्छा लगेगा. और जैसा ऑल स्पीकर्स बोले थे, इट्स ए मूवमेंट. स्पेशली संदेश सर तो हमेशा ही बोलते हैं इट्स ए मूवमेंट, अवार्ड इज ए मूवमेंट. एंड अब अच्छे लोगों को दादागिरी करनी पड़ेगी. मेरा ये कहना है कि अच्छे लोग दादागिरी नहीं करते, अच्छे लोगों को बहुत आगे आना पड़ेगा, वो भी दादागिरी के साथ में, अच्छी दादागिरी के साथ में, एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेशन के साथ में. एंड आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू अवर ई गवर्नेंस एंड मीडिया टीम्स एंड अवर पीयूस, अवर टीम्स सपना, गौरव एंड ऑल अवर टीम्स, शिवानी, शिखा, राहुल, ऑल थैंक यू वेरी मच. थैंक यू टू ऑल विद द चेयरमैन ऑफ पर्सन आशा मैम, मित्तल साहब. मैं कंक्लूड करूं, समाप्त करें इस प्रोग्राम को. सिंधे सर थैंक यू. रमेश मित्तल साहब थैंक यू वेरी मच सर.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू सर.
बाय बाय बाय.
थैंक यू ऑल.